we're gonna do a car ride, but I'm not in my car, I'm in my mom's car. So the setup is a little bit different. So, what's up guys? What are you guys doing today? I am taking my mom's truck to go get fixed because it's sounding kind of crazy. Let's find something on the radio. Guys, dude, if you're a Sharks fan, they kicked ass yesterday. They won 7-0. 7-0. Fucking crazy, dude. Let me tell you guys, so I'm getting such a good response on my video from last week. I did the video last week, but I barely uploaded it Monday. And I've been getting a lot of good feedback from it and everything, so I'm really happy about that. Oh, have you guys tried the new unicorn drink from Starbucks, the unicorn frappuccino? I really want to try it. I think I'm going to get it after my uncle fixes the truck. I'm going to stop at Starbucks. I haven't had Starbucks today. Sunday was the first playoff home game for the Sharks. But it was Easter, so I didn't get to go because I was spending time with my family. And then yesterday was the second home game. So the first home game, they gave shirts. There were shirts on all the seats. That was for the first home game. Yesterday's home game was rally towels, and some of the seats had shirts because some of the shirts made the seats read either wreck the rig or turn up the tank. I can't remember, but they use shirts to like spell stuff out. It looked really, really good. And there was an LED show before the game both days. Super, 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 super dope. I was there was it the beginning of this season? No. Was it? I think it was the beginning of this season and they had the LED show. That's when they first did it, I think. Oh, was it? I think it was. Anyways, back to what I was saying about the LED show. So they first did it at the end of last season, right? Fuck it, I don't remember, but they did it one year at the end of the season, and then they did it again at the beginning of the next season. That's when I got to see it. And then they did it Easter Sunday, and yesterday they did the LED show, and it looks so fucking dope. I'm so sad I didn't go. I really wanted to go. So sad. And we love to stay for us. We crave a different kind of ball. Let me be your ruler. You can call me creepy. Dude, I look a hot damn mess. Have no makeup on, none. No eyelashes, no eyebrows, nada. Cause I seriously don't feel good. But what I'm so excited for this weekend is Monster Jam. That's what I'm like ridiculously excited for. Cause we're all going, I'm so So yesterday was when this car, when the trucks first started acting up, and I was like, oh shit, maybe it needs oil. So then I go to I go to AutoZone to go get a couple of things of oil. And I'm in there and I'm paying for the stuff, and the guy goes, hey miss, is this all you need? And I was like, yeah, this is it. And then he's like, all right, cool. He's like, are you sure you don't need anything else? Do you need me to help you? And I was like, no, I'm okay. And then he was like, all right, cool. And then he like rings it up and it comes out to like 21 something. He's like, damn, that's expensive. He's like, I stick to the, to, what do you say, to the generic or something like that. And I was like, okay. I was gonna be like, well, I have a BMW, so, but I didn't. I was like, okay, whatever. And then he's like, are you sure you don't need anything else? Like, trying to be real, like, slick and shit. And I'm just like, no, dude, like, it's so unattractive. Like, just stop. And I was like, no, I'm okay. So then I was like, oh, do you have a funnel? Do you have a paper funnel that I can have? He's like, I got a plastic one that you can use. He's like, and I'll give you some napkins. Just bring it back, all right? And I was like, all right. It's okay, I can use a paper one, I don't mind, I'll just throw it away. He's like, no, it's cool, I'll give you a good one, don't even trip. And I was like, boy, stop. Like, I was like, all right, cool, thanks. So he gives it to me. I go out, I come out to the truck. I undo the oil. And I pour it in, whatever. And then I'm cleaning out the little filter, not filter, but the funnel. And I take it back inside. He's like, are you cool? Do you need anything else? And I was like, no. How do you say it like that? I was like, no, I'm all right, thanks. And then I left. But it's like, dude, it's so unattractive when guys try so hard. Like, mind you, and I know he was trying, because when some other girl went inside, and I did have my makeup done yesterday. Some other girl went inside, he was like, all right, how can I help you? Like, all, like, different and shit. And I was just like, no, stop. Don't do that. It's not cute at all. Okay, so I had to take an Uber from San Jose to Santa Clara because I had to go do something for my mom. And I didn't want to drive the truck because, I mean, it's not fixed yet. And so, I don't know what's on it. So instead of taking the truck, I just went on an, I just got an Uber. And the first Uber, she was super cool. She was really quiet, but I mean, I didn't mind. I don't feel good anyway, so I didn't feel like talking to anybody and everything. And I asked her, I was like, hey, I was like, when we get there, can, you know, we finish the Uber and then I request another one, and you know, you can you like, you know, drive me back to my house? And she was like, yeah, I think that's fine. She's like, as long as it comes up, it'll be cool. And I was like, okay. Mind you, she like waited right there, so that way when I re-requested the Uber to go back home, it would be her. It wasn't, and I was so sad because this other guy, it was for this other guy. Excuse me. And he shows up, and dude, I should have known it was this guy. He shows up, and he was like, are you Steph? And I was like, yeah. And he was like, all right, cool, get in. And I was like, I don't like this. So I get in. Mind you, where he picked me up from, it was in front of a school, so you're supposed to drive pretty slow in the school zone, and he was not. And I was just like, okay. So we take off, whatever, and we get to the main street, and he almost like takes off and goes into the main street, but then he like stops and he backs up a little bit because cars were passing by, and then he finally gets back onto the main street, and then he turns again before we get to the, so that way we could get to the freeway. But before we got to the freeway, there was a red light. Dude, tell me why this fool like steps on the brake and was like not making noise. If he didn't have good brakes, I'm pretty sure it would have made a noise, because he hella steps on the brakes. And and then we jerked. I had to move the car because they're gonna start fixing it. Oh, I can't switch the camera, but hold on, let me show you. They pulled up the the hood. He's gonna start working on it. Anyways, okay, on the Uber app, when you're in an Uber, when you're on an Uber ride or in an Uber or however you say it, it, and you have if you have Snapchat, it unlocks filters, and I'll insert them right now. And so it said that I had 21 minutes to get home. Then, let's see how long it takes, because I don't know. I'll insert it so that way you guys can see it. Dude, it took 15 minutes to get home from Santa Clara. Like, where was I by? But it was pretty kind of deep into Santa Clara, and then we drove all the way back to the east side. I wish I could play my music that I have on my phone and record at the same time, but I can't, which sucks. So it only took us 15 minutes to get back to the east side, and I was like, damn, dude, because on the filter it said it would take 21 minutes. So then I got home and it was barely 2:08, and I asked my mom, I was like, see what time it said on my snap that we left, and then I'll see how long it took to get back. And yeah, we did the math and it only took like 15 minutes to get back, and or something like that. And then I was like, he was seriously driving like a bat out of hell. Like, we were getting on the freeway, 101, and we were on the carpool lane, and this Navi got in front of him. Was it a Navi? Yeah, a Navi got in front of him, and he was like, asshole. And I was like, bro, it's not that serious. Like, I know that, you know, if you don't have anybody else in the car, cool, whatever, but you have passengers in the car, you have people's lives in your hands, like, oh, you're all homeboy. So 101, 680, and we get off on Jackson because there was another guy in the car, and his name was JJ. If you know me, you know why that's funny. So we get off on Jackson to drop off the other guy, and I don't know if he wasn't paying attention to his navigation or what, but he hella like and turns to the right hella quick, like super quick, and I like literally that's how it happened. And then the street curves to the left, so then he turns this way and we're like, oh shit, dude, like, whoa, bro, like, you cray cray. We get to, so then we drop off the guy that was in the back seat, and we're gonna go drop, then he's gonna go drop me off, and then he turns to get to the light. And then we turn again to get onto Story. And then he was like, he goes, are you from here? And I was like, yeah. And he's, do you live around here? Yeah. And he goes, oh, so what's a good place to eat around here that's like, you know, nearby? And then I was like, well, in this particular area, I was like, oh, if you want fast food, I was like, there's a couple of places. He's like, no, he's like, I kind of want to, like, sit down restaurant. And I was like, okay, well, I'm all, there's a Super Taqueria. I was like, it's right there on Story and White. And then he was like, okay, do you like it there? And I was like, yeah, it's I like it, it's good. And he was like, oh, well, what's good there? And I was like, the burritos are good, tacos are good, you know, everything's pretty good there. He's like, okay, what's your favorite? And I was like, being kind of aggressive here, sir. Excuse me. And I was like, the burritos are good. I was like, I like the carne asada burritos. It's actually what I had today for lunch, so. And then he was like, oh, okay. And so we're getting close to the apartments where I live. And then he was like, he goes, oh, is it up here more? And I was like, yeah, it is. It's like right here, Mom, at the light, you're gonna turn right into the apartment. And so I go, I told him before he even gets to the light, I go, you, when you get to the light, you're going to turn right into the apartments. It's right after the little creek. And he was like, okay, okay, I got it. And so then we get to the light and he goes, oh, the next one's like, no, 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 this one right here, dude, he fucking busts it hella quick. And I was like, I swear, I think I have, what's it called? Whiplash? Is that what it's called? Pretty sure I have that. My neck hurts now. That was a pretty scary, that's like probably one of the worst Uber rides I've ever had. Yo, did you guys hear about Aaron Hernandez? So sad. Yeah, it's really sad. I think it's really sad because no one knows what demons he was fighting on the inside, whether he committed the crime that they put him in jail for or not. Only he really truly knows. No prosecution, no judge, no jury, no nobody. Only him and God know what really happened, and only him and God, he has to get right with God when, you know, he sees him when he died, when he saw him when he died, and only God knows if he let him into the kingdom of heaven or, you know, what he did with him. So my heart and my prayers go out to his family, because a death is a death, suicide or not, it sucks. Death sucks. But like I said, nobody knows what demons he was fighting. Nobody knows. Only he knows, and only God knows, and only God can help him and heal him. And I hope that he got to speak with God before he died. I really do. To end this on a brighter note, I'm gonna go get myself a unicorn frappuccino in a little bit. But for now, I'm going to chill. I'm gonna watch one of my shows on my tablets. All right, I'll see you guys in a few. Much better. So Wilma is fixed. She sounds so much better. But I have to go run another errand for my mom. But before that, I'm going to go to Starbucks and get myself a unicorn frappuccino because I really want to try one. Let's enjoy this. Dude, she sounds so much better now. She drives so much better now. Like, you guys have no idea. I was so scared to drive Wilma. Wilma's the truck, by the way, in case you didn't know. And also, another thing is, I never drive my mom's truck. Never. The only reason I've been driving a truck, like, the last, like, maybe 2 weeks or so, is because she's been really busy with work. I actually heard this song before it even came out on the radio, because Boo Boo showed it to me, or let me listen to it. Okay, thank you. Can I get that drink that everybody's getting today? The unicorn frappuccino?
The black coffee?
Grande?
Yeah, no problem.
And that's it. Thank you. I think this is my CD. I think somebody made me this CD. I'm literally honest. Alright, let's try this, guys. Ooh! This blue stuff is sour. Ooh, but damn, this is good. That's what it looks like. Yo. You know what it kind of tastes like? Okay, so it kind of tastes like... I want to take the top. It kind of tastes like strawberry milk. Kinda. That blue stuff is sour, but it's good. If you know me, I love sour candy. Love sour candy. Not sprinkles, not the word I'm looking for. Sugar. It has like powder, sugar, whatever shit on top. That is sour too, and that's hella good. Oh my god, dude, this is so good. They need to make this permanent. I like it. I would definitely buy it again. I say everybody try it. One time though. Try it.
It looks like super double chin. I really don't have that much of a double chin, I swear. It's like this little part that's right here. But I've always had it, like, forever. It's so weird. Anywho, sir. Oh. Okay, dude. Don't even look. It's cool. We didn't come for money. Stop there, wait. Being chip.
This guy leaving chip?
Yep, he's leaving chip.
Is he not leaving? No? That's not. Okay, so it'll. I chipped my nail. Fudge. I'm trying to let my nails grow and I chipped this one.
Dude, I just saw this guy. He was walking along the street and he looked like Max from once in a lifetime opportunity for you. Como se dice,